you want to use Linux for networking or network admin, you need to know these five commands. First off, ifconfig to configure network interfaces. This is your go-to for viewing and configuring network interfaces. Now, it's been replaced by IP in some systems, but it is still widely used. So if I use ifconfig, run this, what do I get? I get all of this information. This shows IP addresses, net masks, and more. And you can use this to bring interfaces up or down. So for instance, you could choose your interface. You'd run ifconfig like so, but I could have ifconfig. I could have an interface called eth0 and I could say down or up. Now, this is a very simple but powerful command. And as always, I'd recommend using the man to run with ifconfig and to dive deep into documentation to become really great at using it. Of course, there's a lot of networking knowledge and skills you need to have to go with this. Familiarity with IP addresses, CIDR blocks, netmask, etc. But ifconfig, you need this command in your arsenal if you want to do any network admin on Linux. Next up is ping. Everybody knows ping. Ping is the first tool to grab to check if a host is reachable. It sends ICMP packets and measures response times. Now, this command I've got here, I've set a flag of C4 just to limit it to 4 pings. The idea here is if I get responses, the connection is working, no response, it's time to dig deeper. So I'll hit enter and let's see what we get. And we're getting a response and the latency is fairly low, 0% packet loss, 4 received. And remember, ping is essentially a request for a receipt. So we're saying, hey, here's a message, please respond to me. And the idea is that it confirms that the host is available. Next up, we have traceroute. This is to trace the path. It traces the path. It maps the path packets take to reach a destination. So it shows every hop along the way. So for instance, I could use the traceroute command with google.com. And we can take a look at the output. And we can see we've got home, and we can see that we get there. So if you take a look at here, we look at every hop. See, it's numbered 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's the number of hops that were taken to reach google.com. Now, for me, just as a network nerd, I find this really interesting. You can see all the different hosts, all the different paths that you're connected to, all the different hops that it takes to find the server where google.com is hosted. Now, the key point with this output is something wrong? Is something timing out? You can see you've got the response times there in milliseconds. And if there is a response that doesn't give you a time, then you know that it's timing out and that it is time to figure out what is going wrong. When it comes to routing, traceroute is the thing you need to bear in mind when doing network admin on Linux. Now let's talk about netstat. We use this to monitor network connections. It lists all active connections, listening ports, and network statistics. And we're using the flag with TULN, will also show TCP and UDP connections with numerical addresses, which is perfect for finding out what's using a port. And there we go. I get a look at all of my TCP and UDPs, and I can see all the connections with numerical addresses and to see the state as well. Some are listening and some are doing nothing. So when it comes to listening and looking out for active connections in the ports, netstat is the way to go. And then we have SS. Now, SS is the faster and more detailed version than netstat. In many ways, it is the modern netstat. So you can use two, you can use both, that's fine. And SS might be a better tool for modern systems, but all the same, it's got the same flags, but with a more detailed output. And use it to monitor your server's network health. So here is SS. We can use the TULN flag again. Take a look, and there we go. UDP and TCP. We've got the state whether it's on listening or unconnected. Now notice when we looked at netstat, it showed listen or nothing. Here is explicitly saying whether it's connected or not. You can look at the received and sent. You can look at the local address and the port. So if you look at what we just saw a minute ago, and I'll even run it again, netstat, you can see the difference. You've got more detail when we take a look over here at SS compared to netstat. And that's it. That is a quick rundown of five essential Linux networking commands. Even if you're just on a home network, even if you're just connecting to the internet and trying to figure out what's going on, knowing how to use these tools can make your life so much easier when you are at the Linux command line. And of course, if you're interested in a more of a deep dive into any of this in the future, feel free to let me know in the comments and we can always look at making a video that goes deeper into any or all of these commands. But as always, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I can't wait to see you in the next one.